The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 16, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 10th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Bahirantasya bhutanam ataram charameva sukhatyam tat abhigyam durastham chanti ketata. The Supreme Truth, Absolute Truth, or the Supreme Personality of Godhead, we should always remember the Supreme Truth in the ultimate issue is the person. Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti, Shabda. Without understanding this tattva, we cannot understand the Absolute Truth. The first realization is impersonal Brahma. Then, still further advanced realization is localized Paramatma. And still further advanced realization is the Supreme Personality of God. Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti, Sabda. Vadanti, Tattva, Tavidas, Tattvam. Jajjnanam Advayam, Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti, Sabda. The Absolute Truth, the same objective. Today, less intelligent class of men, or in the beginners, he appears to be impersonal. Brahma, impersonal Brahma. Just like the same example. As we are very, very far away, 90 million miles away from the sun planet, we can touch the sun sign, not the sun planet. That is not possible. We have no such power that we can touch the, although the sun planet is there, everyone can go and touch it, but it is beyond our power. This is the position of our material experience, and what to speak of spiritual experience. About the spiritual experience, it is stated in the Brahma Sangita, Panthastu koti satavatsa sampragamya. Vayu rathapi manaso manipungamana. Chappastija prabhadasena avichinta tatte govindamadi purusantamaham bhaja. There is a planet, just like you see the sun planet. It is in your front, you are daily seeing it, but you have no power to go there. This is about the material planet and how you can approach the spiritual planet where Krishna lives. Goloka Vrindavan. Goloka eva nivasati. Everything is there, but you require power to reach. We can realize in the beginning the sun sign. Then, if we are able to approach the sun planet, that also not possible, but still we can hope. But still you have to enter the sun planet and there is sun god. From the sun god, the glaring effulgence, the sun sign is coming. Although the sun sign and the sun globe and the within the sun globe, the sun god, they are of the same thing, quality, light and heat. Still there are degrees of light and heat. You can touch the sun sign, but you cannot touch the sun glow. Neither you can enter the sun glow. That requires a different power. So, this is material. And now, this sun shining and the sun glow is also stated in the Brahma Sangita that Yatchaksuresa sabita sakalam grahana raja samastasura murti asesa teja jasyagnaya bhramati sang hrutakala chakro Govindamadi Purusam Tamang Bhaja. Now this sun globe, it is very powerful planet within this universe. Therefore it is called the king of all planets. Jatrapsuresa Sabita. Sabita means the sun planet. Sakalagrahanang Raja. Samasta Suramurti Asesa Teja. Unlimited power. Asesa Teja. But still, this sun planet is also moving in its orbit. The sun planet has got its orbit. All planets, they have got their orbit. Jasyagvaya Bhramatisam Vrita Kalachakra. It is moving like that. 16,000 miles per second, the speed of sun planet. Everything is described in the Srimad Bhagavata. So, it's still such a big planet, powerful planet, it is rotating under someone's order. That is Govinda. Jasyagmaya Bhramatisam Vrita Kala Chakra Govinda Madhi Purusam Samangala. There must be someone directing. Don't think it is automatically moving. There is direction. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Maya Dhakshena Prakriti Suratesa Characharam Hetunanena Pauntya Jagad Viparivartate. So, we are not so intelligent to understand that the material nature is working, moving under the direction of the Supreme Personality. But we can experience it. Just like a machine, computer, a very subtle machine, it is working wonderfully. But there is a person who is pushing the button. Without that, the machine is useless. It is a lump of matter. Similarly, this gigantic universe, cosmic manifestation, nature is working very wonderfully. The sun is moving, moon is moving, and the earth is moving, everything in the right direction and minute time, and not a single inch is moving here or there. Everything is going on nicely. How? That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Vaya dhakshena prakriti suyate sa characharam hetunanena pauntya jagadvi parivartate. It is under the direction of the Supreme Personality of God. So, Gyan, Krishna is explaining the subject matter of knowledge. First of all, Krishna has explained the process of knowledge. Amanittam madam mittam khanti ajavam mai chananna yogena bhakti yoga abhyavicharini. Janma mrittu jarabhyadi dukkha dosanu darshanam. These are the process of knowledge. To know, if we remain before, ignorant, that we are missing the chance, everything we can know. This human form of body is specially meant for that purpose. You can understand what you are, what is this material nature, what is God, and how we are related, how things are going on. Everything is there. But we are so foolish that we do not take care. We live like cats and dogs, eat something, and sleep, and have sexual intercourse, and then we are afraid always, and then die. This is cats and dogs' life. Real life is to know Athata Brahma Jignyasa. That is real life, human life. One must be inquisitive to understand the Absolute Truth, Brahma Jignyasa. Not inquiring in the market what is the rate of share, what is the rate of rice. No, not for this inquiry. Jignyasu Sreya Uttamam. To inquire about the Absolute Truth, Uttamam, beyond this material nature. Udgata Tamam. This material nature is called Tamam. Tamasi Ma Jyotirgamam. These are the Vedic engines. You have to enter. You have to understand. The world of light, this world is the world of darkness. It is simply, we require therefore sunlight, moonlight, electric light. Otherwise it is dark. It is called tama. But there is another world which is full of light. It is so full of light that it do not require the sunlight, moonlight or electric light there. Natatra bhasate surya na sasanka na pavaka yadgatyana nivartante tadhamam paramam. The spiritual world there is. Parastasmatu bhava anya vatya vatya sanatana. Everything is there. But we do not take care. We think that we have understood 3 vigas of land, my neighborhood, or this, my India, or my America, or this planet, that is sufficient knowledge. No, that is not sufficient knowledge. You have to know so many things. But if you understand Krishna, to understand Krishna means to understand everything. Jasmin vijñāte sarvam idam vijñātam bhavati. If you try to, this Krishna consciousness movement is that try to understand Krishna as Krishna is speaking in the Bhagavad Gita. Don't malinterpret. Don't be foolish that Krishna means this, Kurukshetra means that, manufacture some words and you be also foolish and make others foolish. No. Try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is. Then you'll understand everything. Now here Krishna says, Bahirantasya bhutanam. The absolute truth is there. Bahirantasya. Not that it is in a different position or different angle of vision. You are already in the absolute truth. Even materially conception. Bhumi rapanalo bhāyu khaṅga buddhi mana. These are the material elements, 5 gross elements and 3 subtle elements. So, in taking materially, what is this material? We have already explained. The materials are different energies of the Supreme Lord. Vindame prajiti asadha, Krishna says, these 8 kinds of material nature, subtle and gross, they are my energy. Inferior energy. It has to be made for getting for us. So, the mind is within, the intelligence is within, the soul is within, and outside your body. So this body made of 5 elements, they are also Krishna's energy. And within, the mind, intelligence and the soul, that is also Krishna's energy. 2 kinds of energies. Inferior and superior. Therefore, he is outside and inside. Both. Bahirantasya bhutana. Every living entity, Krishna is existing outside and inside. Therefore we have to purify both outside and inside. That is our human life. Human life means to become purified. Because we are not purified, therefore we have to accept birth, death, old age and disease. This is the problem. Because we are not purified, that is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Tapo Digvama Putra Kajina Suddheta Satta. Rishabdev advised his sons, my dear sons, Tapo Digvama, just undergo austerities. This life, human life, is for austerity, penance. Therefore you find in the Vedic civilization, big saintly persons, big brahmins, kshatriyas, rajarshis, they are engaged. Just like Lord Buddha. Lord Buddha was the prince, royal family. But still, he left everything and underwent meditation to understand himself. There are many others, Bharat Maharaj, under whose name this country is called Bharatvarsha. At the 24th years of his age, he left his kingdom, his wife, little children, and went for austerity, penance. This is meant for, this life is meant for not to live extravagantly, without any responsibility, like cats and dogs. We should be very responsible. austerity, little austerity. In the Kali Yuga, you cannot undergo severe austerity. But even if you follow little austerity, little something must be done. Little austerity, just like you do not commit any sinful life. What is that? No illicit sex, no meat eating, no intoxication, no gambling. This much austerity. If you simply accept this four principles, now these Europeans and Americans, they are accepting. And see how they are advancing. You cannot understand the supreme pure, absolute truth, keeping yourself impure. It is not possible. You can understand God when you are pure. Jisam antagatama papam. It is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. You can understand God if you are sinful. Namang duskitana mūḥā prapadyante narādhamā. Those who are not purified, sinful, acting only sinfully, such person is called duskritina. Kritina, kriti means meritorious. But these rascals are meritorious in doing all sinful activities. Sinful activities also require merit. Even if you become a very expert thief, this is stealing a sinful activity. But it requires some brain. It requires some brain. Therefore, the word is used, kritino. Kritino means meritorious. But duskritino, their merit is being applied for sinful activity. Similarly, there is another word, sukritino. You can employ your merit for pious activities. The merit is the same. Just like money. Money you can utilize for duskritino and for sukritino. You can utilize your money for drinking wine, illicit sex, meat eating and gambling. And you can utilize your money for Krishna service, for offering yajnas, for constructing temple, sacrifices, push on the Sankirtan movement, Krishna consciousness movement. So money is not good or bad, as you utilize it. Similarly, merit also. There, you have got already merit, better than the animals, but you have to utilize it for proper service. That is called Krishna consciousness. Consciousness we have got, merit we have got. Simply, we have to utilize. Now, here Krishna says that bohirantasya bhutana. You have to undergo austerities to see Krishna both outside and inside. If you understand this philosophy, then your life is successful. Antarvahi. Aradhita jadi harish tamasa tata kim. Naradhita jadi harish tamasa tata kim. Antar bahi jadi haris, tamasa tatap kim. Nantar bahi jadi haris, tamasa tatap kim. If you can see Krishna, antar within and bahi outside, then you are all tamasa finished. You are perfect now. Tamasa tatap kim, no more tamasa. And if you cannot see the Supreme Lord, inside and outside, then you may undergo various types of tapasya and education. It is all useless. Useless waste of time. Dharma sāna sthita pungsāṁ viṣṣakṣi na kathāsuja nūtpāda edhratiṁ jadi sramaye vahi keva. If you cannot understand the viṣṣakṣi na, Vishakshana is another name of Krishna or God. Vishakshana kathasuja, dharma sāna sthita punta. I am learned Brahmin. I am very expert kshatriya, I am expert vaishya. This is called dharma, varnasram dharma. Even if you execute your varnasram dharma, nobody is executing nowadays. Everyone is sudra, kalau sudra samava. And even if you execute your dharma, Brahman dharma, Kshatriya dharma, Vaishya dharma. But even after doing so, very perfectly, very orderly, if you do not develop your Krishna consciousness, Vishakshena kathasu, no, rooting, if you do not feel attraction, just like here, Vishakshena katha, Krishna katha is going on, but nobody is interested. Nobody is interested. Vishakshena kathasu, rooting, no utpada. There are so many educated persons, but they are not interested. They will be interested to go to cinema, to the drinking house, to the meat-eating hotel. They are interested. This is the position of Kali. Manda samanda matayo manda bhagya adhipaddhita. Therefore they are so unfortunate. Always disturbed. Always disturbed. Manda samanda matayo. Prahena alpaya ayusa kalau asmin jugijana. First qualification is they do not live long. A very short period of life. And it's still manda, very bad. Manda matayo. And they have got their philosophy, something God's killed them. Mandamata mandamatayo sumandamatayo mandabhagya. And all unfortunate. They cannot eat even properly. There is no milk, there is no ghee, there is no rice. This is the position of Kali Yuga. So, therefore in this age, if we want to save ourselves from this onslaught of this age, the proposition is, Kalau dosa nidhe rajan asti jipa mahan guru. Parikshit Maharaj was informed by Sukadev Goswami, my dear king. I have described about the faulty nature of this age. Kalau dosa nidhi, there is an ocean of faults. But there is one good opportunity. Kalau dosa nidhi rajan asti jipa mahan guru. There is one good quality. What is that? Kītanāreva Krishnasya mukta saṅga parambari. Simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, one can become free from all this contamination and he can go back to home, back to life. This is another advantage of Kali Yuga. In other job, one has to undergo so much severe austerity, penances, then one can realize. But in these days, the things have been made easy. That is also mercy of Krishna, because these people are so much disturbed and fallen, downtrodden. They cannot undergo very severe austerity. Simply chant. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama Iva Kevalam. Kalau Nasti Iva Nasti Iva Nasti Iva Gatirannatha. These are the Shastri injunctions. And actually it is happening in Europe and America. They are simply chanting this Hare Krishna mantra. They are advancing very quickly. To understand this Bhagavad Gita, they are now reading as it is. The latest report is in London, we are selling 15,000 copies per month. So they are taking interest. Because it is presented as it is, Bhagavad Gita as it is. No rascal interpretation. This meaning is this, this meaning that. What authority have got to make like that? Try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is, then you will be benefited. So, one has to understand the Supreme Absolute Truth both outside and inside. Antar bahir sabhutana charam acharam eva. There are two things. Some of them are moving or with life, and some of them are not moving, even living beings. Here it is called Bhutana. Bhutana means living entities. So there are some living entities which are moving, just like we, cats, dogs, human beings, and flies, and so many living beings are moving. And other living beings, just like trees, plants, are standing one place. Sthavar jangam. Sthavar means one place. Chara acharam. Sukhatvat, in every living being, there is the Supreme Law. Supreme Law. Andan tarastham paramanu chayan tarastham. Even within the atom. Sukhatvat, avijñam, because it is so small, minute. That minute means that Krishna's part and parcel. Krishna is the gigantic, Virat or Vibhu, and we living entities, we are Omu. The Sukhatvat, Sukhatvat called Avijñam. Because we have already explained this. Our eyes, they cannot see the subtle things, minute things. We require some instrument. That's like microscope. But even with microscope, our so-called microscope cannot see what is that soul. It is very, very minute. 10,000 part of the upper portion of the ear. Jiva bhava savidhya. Kesagrasa satobhagas. Kesagra, the tip of the hair. Satobhagas, you divide into 100 and then take one part, again divide into 100. Kesagra satobhagasa satodhakalpitasya. That 10,000 part of the tip of this. It is so many. But there is the thing. Very minute, just like a small grain of a poison, venomous poison. If it is injected in your body, you will die. It has got so power. Similarly, the minute spirit soul is so minute, 1/10,000 part. Still, because this minute spirit soul is there, you are moving, you are acting, your brain is working, you are denying the existence of God. You are doing all this. Sukhatatad avijñam durastham. Durastham chantiketatat. Durastham. Now you cannot calculate where this abode of God is there. Durastham. Panthasya koti satavasya. If you go with your plane, with the speed of mind, panthasya koti satavasya sampradamma. Bayurathapi, by aeroplane, Bayurath. This Bayu aeroplane is mentioned in the Brahma Sangha. Bayurathapi, manasu, and with the speed of mind. Munipungamana, discovered by great scientists, is still avichintatatte. It is so far away. Avichintatatte. Therefore it is called durastam. At the same time, Antike, very near, just like Krishna is standing here. One has to understand. Very near, he has kindly come to you, near, so near that you can touch his lotus feet, you can offer him some food stuff, you can decorate. He's agreeing, yes, I will accept you. Patram puspam phalam toyam, jomi bhakta prajacchati. And the, before this, Krishna said, Sarvato Panipadasta. He has got hands and legs everyone. In the Vedas also it is confirmed. Apanipada, Javanagrahita. Apanipada. He has no hands and legs, but whatever you offer in sacrifice, he immediately accepts. How he accepts? How he accepts? That is called Durastham. Very, very far away. At the same time, Antike, immediately. Provided you know the means, if you know, then you can see. Premangana charita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva rileshu vilokanti. That is God's power. He can remain far, far away, but he can immediately be approachable by the devotee. There is another verse. Adyaita Achyuta Yanadi Ananta Rupam Adyanga Purana Purushanga Namajavane Vedesu Dullava Adullava Atava Tau Vedesu Dullava. If you want to understand the absolute truth by simply studying the Vedas, although the Vedas means Vedaisya Sarvai Ahamiva Vedna. Krishna is to be understood. That is the Vedic object. But if you have no devotional feeling, then even if you go on reading Vedic literature for many millions of years, you will not understand what is this. Try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is and your life will be successful. Thank you very much.